Want to add a personal touch to your Christmas decorations this year? Why not make your own LED Christmas lights using a 555 timer? Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to make LED Christmas lights using the 555 timer IC. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. Two alligator clips, one 100,000 ohm resistor, one 150 ohms resistor, one 100 ohms resistor, 9 jumper wires, one 555 timer IC, one 10 microfarad capacitor, two green LEDs, two red LEDs, one 9-volt battery for the power source, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2, the trigger pin, initiates the timing interval in monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 serves as the output, providing the timer's operational result depending on its mode: monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4, the reset pin, is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 serves as the control pin, enabling you to adjust the threshold voltage levels used by the internal comparators to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6, the threshold pin, monitors the voltage of the capacitor in the circuit. Pin 7, the discharge pin, manages the timing capacitor's charge and discharge cycle. Pin 8, known as VCC, supplies power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Turn the breadboard to the side. Bend the ends of a 100,000 ohms resistor. Insert the 100,000 ohms resistor to pin 2 or trigger and pin 3 or output. Insert a 10 microfarad capacitor to pin 2 or trigger and the negative rail. Insert the shorter leg into the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire from pin 3 or output to several rows below the IC. In this circuit, the other end of the jumper wire is connected to row 14. Turn the breadboard back to the vertical position. Bend the ends of a 150 ohm resistor. Place the 150 ohms resistor in row 16, with one end connected to the negative rail and the other in the same column as the previous blue jumper wire. Insert a jumper wire to connect the left and right sides of the breadboard. This jumper wire is in row 14. Insert another jumper wire to connect the left and right sides of the breadboard. This jumper wire is in row 16, two rows below the previous one. Insert a green LED in row 14 and row 16. The longer leg is in row 16. Insert a red LED in row 14 and row 16. The longer leg is in row 14. Insert the second green LED in row 14 and row 16. The longer leg is in row 16. Insert the second red LED in row 14 and row 16. The longer leg is in row 14. Notice that the green LEDs have the longer legs in row 16, while the red LEDs have theirs in row 14. Bend the ends of a 100 ohm resistor. Place the 100 ohms resistor in row 16, with one end connected to the red LED and the other positioned next to the positive rail. Insert a jumper wire into the negative rail. Attach the black alligator clip to the jumper wire. Insert a jumper wire into the positive rail. Attach the red alligator clip to the jumper wire. Attach the black alligator clip to the negative terminal of the 9-volt battery. Attach the red alligator clip to the positive terminal. Look at that. The red and green LEDs are alternating just as expected. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. The 555 timer is configured in a stable mode, generating a continuous square wave signal. This square wave alternates the output voltage, or pin 3, between high, which is close to the supply voltage of around 9 volts, and low, which is close to ground, or around 0 volts. The resistor capacitor timing network controls the alternation frequency connected to the 555 timer. When the 555 timer's output, or pin 3, is high, the red LEDs are forward biased, causing them to light up. This happens because the longer legs of the red LEDs, connected to pin 3 via row 14, receive the positive voltage. Meanwhile, the shorter legs of the red LEDs are connected to the negative rail through a 150 ohms resistor, completing the circuit. At the same time, the green LEDs remain off because their longer legs, connected via row 16, do not receive the necessary forward voltage when pin 3 is high. When the output switches to low, the green LEDs light up instead. In this state, the longer legs of the green LEDs connected to the positive rail through a 100 ohms resistor are forward biased. The shorter legs of the green LEDs are connected to pin 3, which is now at 0 volts, completing their circuit. Conversely, the red LEDs turn off because their longer legs are no longer forward biased, as pin 3 is now low. This alternating behavior creates a blinking effect as the circuit switches between the red and green LEDs. The resistor capacitor timing network's values of 100,000 ohms and 10 microfarads determine how fast the LEDs switch. By adjusting these values, you can change the blinking frequency. A larger resistor or capacitor will slow down the blinking. A smaller resistor or capacitor will speed it up. I hope this video has shown you how to make LED Christmas lights with 555 timer ICs. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.